I said to Andrew, if this guy goes under, I'm not going to get into trouble, am I? And he said, no, you're not personally accountable. Well, I'm not, am I?
On the contrary, Diane, I'm afraid you'll have to be flogged.
Try these. Now, the thing that fascinated me about Hopkins, who is that Russian spy, not Philby?
Burgess.
Guy Burgess. I used to think he was like that.
What, you mean gay?
No. Burgess' strategy was to hide in plain sight. People would say to him, what is your political persuasion, Guy? And he'd say, darling, I'm a communist. I mean, it's so clever, telling the truth in a context that makes it seem outrageous.
Yes.
I'd say, exactly why do you want this extension of credit, Mr. Hopkins? And he'd say, because I'm doing incredibly badly, and I have to have another win, or I will be in very serious trouble.
Well, he is now.
The discipline to control your reactions like that.
Tai Chi.
Prone bowls.
It's a Chinese martial art. Develops the harmony of mind and body. Now Mr. Hopkins does it.
Your information on Hopkins is sufficiently detailed to tell you that he does Tai Chi, but not that he's called Leo.
Oh, you know, it's a ragbag.
So, tell me, is it true what they say about Winkley?
Who, sorry?
Head of security. I thought...
Oh, Winkley. God, yeah, absolutely true. The only man who could enter a revolving door behind him come out first.
Who are you? The last time I saw Alice Winkley, she was a woman. You've been following me.
Never at all. Never seen you before in my life, before you got into that lift.
Then how did you know who I was?
I recognized your voice.
What are you doing?
What am I doing? Well, I'm eating dinner with a beautiful and intelligent woman, upon whom I have no lascivious designs. I'm happily married. This is the truth, Diane. Plain sight.
What do you want from me, Mr. Hopkins?
I have a proposition.
And what's to stop me walking straight out of here?
Nothing. Absolutely nothing. Diane, I intend to be truthful with you. So please be truthful with me. Who did you telephone?
My boyfriend.
Right. So he's popping around to beat me up, is he?
I told him where I was, that I was with a client, and that I'd be late. If I'm very late, yes, he will come looking for me.
Thank you. Good. Well, yes. Sensible precaution.
Mr. Hopkins, okay, I will hear this proposition, but don't try me and don't patronize.
I'm sorry. I owe Garrison's £750,000. This debt is overdue.
Yes.
I owe my brother-in-law, Francis, £50,000, that being a combination of his redundancy and a second mortgage. I owe my secretary £11,000, which is her life savings and a salary I haven't paid her. I owe my wife, Jane, £800,000, most of which is for a house she bought for us and I sold. I owe my mother £100, her nest egg. She gave to me to invest for her. I spent it. I owe Action for the Disabled. Far, far more than money. These are relatives, friends, people I value. The list continues. I call it Category A. The total amount owing in this category is £4.75 million. Category B comprises people and institutions for whom I have no affection. They're mostly business associates. Total owing in Category B, excluding garrisons, is £5.5 million.
God almighty.
These sums of money have increased at a constant rate over the last 4 months. Creditors, of course, are ever-changing. That's how it works. You know that circus trick with the spinning dinner plates on the poles?
One or two of your plates have dropped off, Leo.
But the crowd is still with me. And if a glamorous assistant will pass me a couple more, the show can go on. Everybody gets their money's worth.
I think we're getting very close to your proposition. I also think I know what it is. You want to open another account with Garrison's under a false name, using fake ID authenticated by me. You then win enough money to pay the debts that are urgent and pay me for making it possible.
I think you've grasped the essentials.
I'll just become a spinning dish on one of your poles, won't I? A new one?
Yes.
You're a con man, Leo.
I'm not a con man.
Oh, I think you are. I need more information.
Whatever you want.
I need to know why you do it. Why you throw the money away, because that's what you do, isn't it, Leo? You get the money from these people, I don't know how, and you throw it away. 200 grand on a horse at 3-1 when the maximum we pay is £500,000. That's anarchy. Why?
My father was a remarkable man. He understood, although he consistently told me otherwise, that money gets you the things you want. Fact.
But
you also get what you should not have. Instead of which he's festering in a wheelchair with a broken neck. Oh, men and their fathers, Diane. We look at them when we're children and we think, yeah, pretty damn good. Not a bad job of being a man. But I can do better. Have to. It's evolution. I'm the Mark II, streamlined. I can see the design faults. See the mistakes you're making. I won't make them.
Leo, I lied to you. I called the police.
Yes, madam.